Okay, now after balancing equations, now we would be ready to do types of chemical reactions. So we're going to look at four basic types of chemical reactions. They are synthesis, where you take multiple things and put them together, decomposition, where you take one thing and break it apart into many things, replacement, which is like a bunch of date swapping, and then combustion, where you catch stuff on fire. So the first thing that we're going to do is look at the two opposites in this, which are synthesis and decomposition. Synthesis is where you're taking multiple things and synthesizing them together. You're taking multiple things and blending them together. So you are looking for an equation that looks like A plus B makes AB. So you take thing one, thing two, and you put them together to make thing three. So here is an example of a synthesis reaction. You've got P plus O, you make P and O together. So the other key to look for is that you should see a plus sign on the left side, meaning you're adding multiple things together, but not on the right. You shouldn't see any addition sign on the right side of the arrow, okay? So what's decomposition look like? The reverse. Decomposition is where you've got one thing breaking into multiple things. This is where you decompose or you break apart. So this is like where synthesis was A plus B makes AB. This is like saying AB makes A plus B. So here, you should have no plus sign on the left side or the reactant side, which means there's only one reactant, this chunk of stuff right here. And then you should see a plus sign on the product side, which means that there are multiple products. So one reactant, multiple products. Okay, that's what you're looking for. So we'll go ahead and do a couple examples of synthesis and decomposition right here. So here, let's find an example. Let's look at number three. So is this synthesis or decomposition? We have one thing making multiple things. So we got this and this. So that means that we are decomposing. So that's a decomposition reaction. Now let's try and find an example of a synthesis. Look at 10. 10, you have multiple things coming together to make one thing. So you got this plus this makes this. So that means that we are dealing with multiple things synthesizing together. So that would be a synthesis reaction. Okay, now we go on to the other type of replacement. So those can be a little more complex, but they're usually pretty simple. Replacement happens when you are date swapping. So you take one thing and you mix it with something else on the other side. So let's go ahead and do a couple examples of that. What you will find is in a single replacement, you are going to see an element not bonded to a different element on Nike on either side. So right here, we have copper. It's not bonded to anybody else, okay? And then that's carbon. And then over here, we have copper that's not bonded to anybody else over here. Okay, so it's not bonded. But I'm going to kind of do a red bracket for anything that's a couple. But on this side, we got a couple right here. And then over here, we have a couple. So you notice that what I've kind of done with purple brackets here are that you have a single element not bonded to different elements on either side, even though it's not the same one. So where on this side it's carbon, on the other side it's copper. But you're looking to have it by itself and not with any different element. And then here you have a couple. And then if you look at it like dates, copper and oxygen are hanging together, and then carbon is single. I keep doing that. And then on the other side, copper gets dumped by oxygen over here to end up single, and then oxygen is hanging out with carbon. So that gives us a new couple. So there's the single replacement. Now over here, double replacement is kind of more simple. The way you know you're dealing with a replacement, either single or double, is whether or not you see a plus sign, two plus signs on either side of the arrow. Now the next thing is the compounds that come with it. So if it's a double replacement, you don't have any single at all. So here, I'm going to do like a red bracket and then a purple bracket like I did last time. So iron and sulfur are going together. And then the other couple is hydrogen and chlorine going together. But what happens is hydrogen, who was in our purple couple, is now hanging out with sulfur, who was originally in the red couple. And then iron, who was in a red couple, is now hanging out with chlorine, who was part of the purple couple. So now you see that these two have switched partners and have date swapped. So that's where you have a double replacement. So let's go ahead and identify a couple types of those. All right, we'll do single first because it's easier to spot. Okay, the first tips to find a single replacement are, one, do you have a plus on both sides? If yes, you are dealing most likely with a replacement reaction. Both of these have a plus on both sides. So these are both replacement reactions. The next thing, though, is, are they double or are they single replacement? So let's start with 5 first. Argon is hanging out with nitrate, or NO3. We're going to make this simple, and we're going to keep NO3 together as a group because it's in the same arrangement on both sides. Then copper is by itself. Then we get copper hanging out with nitrate. And we've got silver by itself on the other side. So we have one bracket here and one bracket here, which means we have a single element not bonded to any other different element over here on both sides, and it's not the same one. So we are looking, since we have singles on both sides, at a single replacement. If we go up, let's look at this one. We have rubidium, and we have nitrate, and then we have beryllium, and we have fluorine. Then we get beryllium hanging out with nitrate, and then we get rubidium hanging out with fluorine. So we have had the purple couple and the red couple swap partners. This is a double replacement. Okay. Next thing is, well, if we've done those four types, what's the fifth one? Well, I said there were four types, but there's wrong one. There is another type, since replacement goes into two different types. Combustion is where you burn up, okay? That's where you catch on fire. Combustion's easy. You look for these three things. On the left, you need to find O2. On the right, you also need to find carbon dioxide, water, and heat. So let's see if we have, sometimes heat will not be written. So you can give or take that one. So let's go ahead and see if we can find that. O2, CO2, H2O. Aha, 14. We have on the left O2. On the right, we have CO2, H2O. This is combustion. Something is catching on fire. Okay, so I got you started. Go ahead and try the remainder of these reaction types. And if you didn't finish balancing these yesterday, make sure you do so. Refer to the tutorials on Canvas if you had trouble on this yesterday.